It's Mazzy. Folk music. That shit almost caught on. Lead Belly. Ed Belly and his 12 string, probably, you know, more in the blues segment, but really a true American folk singer. Recorded early on by Alan Lomax, as he was, him and his brother John Lomax were searching America for roots music. I'm gonna tell, some notes on some of my record collection of folk music, American folk music, not British folk music this time. And obviously, these things are never a definitive thing. It's kind of stream of thought, showing you my record collection. You know, you could read books, dissertations, and get the whole history elsewhere. But Lead Belly is someone you really need to know about. Died 1949. The song's called Black Snake Moan. In fact, there's a really interesting film. I know I'm getting off subject, off track, but Samuel Jackson and Christina Ricci, Black Snake Moan. You gotta check that out. If nothing else, get on your phones right now and Google Black Snake Moan movie poster and take a look at Christina Ricci in that movie. Looks a little creepy, but it's really a pretty good movie, cult favorite of mine. Anyway, I'm gonna go through some folk music. Obviously, some crossover into the blues, but a lot of the stuff I'm getting into tends to be urban, and we'll talk about that a little bit. But Lead Belly is one that influenced, you know, everyone from Bob Dylan to Pete Seeger to Joan Baez to anyone in the folk scene. Probably a lot of rock and rollers too with the blues as well. Those recordings were issued on Columbia. That's a reissue from the 70s that I got. Another important figure is Elizabeth Cotton. And Folkways, Arhoolie Records Folkways is another important labor of love. Of folk music and roots music that was archived on these Smithsonian recordings. It's related to Arhoolie Records from Chris Strockwitz out of El Cerrito, California. And Arhoolie is now owned. He sold it some years ago to Arhoolie. And in fact, if any of you are flying into SFO, San Francisco, now, not this minute necessarily, but if you go into Terminal 2, I think it's Alaska Airlines and maybe American Airlines is there as well, domestic. There's a what's great about SFO, the United Terminal, I think, which is Terminal 3 and Terminal 2 usually has great art exhibits, but they have a Smithsonian Arhoolie down-home music record exhibit right now. So buy a ticket on Alaska Airways, flying to SFO now. You'll enjoy San Francisco anyway, and enjoy it, and check out that exhibit. But here's some Elizabeth Cotton. I'm just gonna play a few tracks. I'm not putting any vocal groups, any folk vocal groups, like Peter, Paul, and Mary, Kingston Trio. I don't like that, but gotta limit it somewhere. You know, a lot of these, there's certain, it's like, blues riffs, blues bars. This is Freight Train, but it's almost like cocaine, right? Freight Train, cocaine running around my brain. Music. I mean, a way you can say folk music is blues for white people, although it started out as black music, like most white music. and obviously probably the true American white folk singer that you all know, and especially a lot of people my generation knew it from grammar school, singing "This Land Is Your Land, This Land Is My Land." But Woody Guthrie, Dust Bowl Ballads. Look at this cover. If you know of the famous photographs, again, I always bring it back to photography, don't I? But Dorothea Lange's famous photographs of the Dust Bowl. It's on Folkways Records also. And this is a very, very, very old copy of this record. You know, if it wasn't for Woody Guthrie, we wouldn't have Bob Dylan.
1964. This issue of it. The prices up and the rain come down and I hauled my crops all into town. I got the money, bought clothes and groceries, fed the kids and raised the family. Rain quit and the wind got high and a black old dust storm filled the sky and a swamp of farm for a Ford machine and I poured it full of this gas Eileen was started, rocking and rolling. Over the mountains, out towards the old Peach Bowl. Way up yonder on the mountain road, I had a hot motor and a heavy load. I was going pretty fast, I wasn't even stopping, bouncing up and down like popcorn pop.
Anyway, get some Woody Guthrie, you know? Get a collection, anything. You need Woody Guthrie in your collection. If you give a shit about music, you need Woody Guthrie. Now, I'm not going to play a very short bit of this because, as you know, this probably won't last if I go any longer, as they say. You know, if I do, I do. Anyway, first Dylan album. You know, Woody Guthrie, God. Woody Guthrie. Important figure in American music in general. Another important figure that just celebrated his 100th birthday in the grave. It sounds bad taste, doesn't it? But Pete Seeger. Pete Seeger, in fact, there's a great collection that just came out, a big CD box set. I don't have it, but it's multis, like 100th birthday edition. You might want to check out if you like that. But Pete Seeger was part of the trio of the folk group The Weavers. You know, worked for the common man, worked for the unions. Some say he was a commie, filthy commie. It's more the pop stuff, but you know, we move away. In fact, I'm going to skip that one because you know that song. This is a live, I think it's mostly live, but you know his, where he kind of took this song and took from the book of Ecclesiastes of the Bible, and you know someone else doing this song. Top 10 hits for the birds.
A time to be born, a time to die.
Pete Seeger adapted this to music.
A time to read,
Roger McGuinn and the
kill,
group were folk
heal,
singers, folk
heal,
fans.
A time
added a 12-string, backbeat, surefire hit.
There is a season, turn, 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 and a time for every
You know, a lot of the folk labels, obviously Columbia did a lot of folk music, you know, as you see there with Pete Seeger and Bob Dylan, but the real folk labels out of New York and the East Coast in the early 60s, late 50s, early 60s, were Elektra Records, started by Jock Holtzman, Vanguard Records, and Prestige Records, jazz and folk, if you didn't know that. And another artist on Vanguard, and whether you like her or not, she was also a very important artist that came up when Dylan was coming up, and you know her either way, but I'm pretty much picking the first albums of these artists, not definitively, but Joan Baez on Vanguard Records. Interesting enough, this is another album that, another song, The Birds covered, I think on Fifth Dimensions, called John Riley. Beautiful voice. I mean, her stuff even with Dylan. Another very important artist of the folk scene in the early 60s, also on Vanguard Records, was Odetta. And this is a classic album on Vanguard that, I know what I'm gonna play, but live, Odetta live at Carnegie Hall. With notes by Harry Belafonte on the album cover. It's the same song I just played to you by Joan Baez. You know, there's a lot of standards that all the folk singers would play. John Riley is one of them. John Henry. A lot of songs about John, you know. But you could, if I had a hammer, you could go through Peter, Paul, and Mary's repertoire, go through Dylan's early, Joan Baez, Odetta, and, you know, someone like my next artist, who is one of my favorites, and I mentioned him once on, maybe it was a Whack-A-Mole or one of my other ones, but Tom Rush. His first few albums were on Prestige Records, and then he switched to Elektra Records. And as I said, you know, he got more rootsy, country, folky in the early 70s. And I think he wrote a song around 1970 called No Regrets that in 95 became a hit for the Walker Brothers reunion. They copied that song, or they covered it, I should say, and did a different, very similar version, but No Regrets is a great song, but this is not that. But I have to play this because of my hometown. A lot of people did this song too. Even Paul McCartney covered this song. San Francisco Bay Blues. I should have done a video of just everyone covering this song. There you go, right? Tom Rush. Mind rambling. You know, folk singers in the urban days of New York and the urban folk scene of the early 60s love to ramble. I love to ramble. I just realized someone I forgot. I didn't bring him in here, but Tom Paxton is someone I forgot who was also on Elektra Records for a time. But this is an important figure who crosses over blues and folk, but I see him more as a great blues artist. And I brought three albums here. I'm only going to play one, only because they're amongst my favorite album covers. Now, this guy's got soul with his folk music.
Hey, look a yonder, what in the world it will see? That midnight special.
Look at this one.
It's light on me.
Yeah, you know the song by Creedence Clearwater, but
shines light on me. At the midnight special shines ever a
gorgeous cover.
If you ever go to Houston, you better walk right, or you better not stagger, and you better not fight. The sheriff will arrest you, and he'll take you down. You bet your bottom dollar that's your jailhouse bound. Then you wake up in the morning.
Sonny Greer, Al Hall, and Josh Wright. That's a fucking great trio. Sonny Greer played with Duke Ellington.
On the table is a knife, fork, and a pan. Say anything about it.
Okay.
You have to.
I know after I hang up from you, Mooks, I'm going on to some just three Josh White records in a row. Not that wimpy white fucking folk music shit. I kid. Speaking about wimpy white folk singers. No, she's not wimpy. One of the most, definitely one of the most beautiful women in the folk scene in the early 60s with probably the most gorgeous, translucent eyes you've ever seen in your entire life, with influenced and made Steve Stills write a song about her, Sweet Judy Blue Eyes, right? Well, here's Sweet Judy's first album. And she says, she does John Riley on here too. Won't play it though. I mean, you know, I forgot that, I'm not sure which album it is. Maybe it is this album. No, it's not this album. But on several of these early albums on Elektra Records, Roger McGuinn, Jim McGuinn, played guitar and banjo on some of these early Elektra Records. So he really came from the folk scene. And it's interesting here, I was looking at this, not only John Riley is on here yet again, that the Byrds covered, but also is Wild Mountain Time that the Byrds also covered. So, you know, the Byrds were like the ultimate folk rock band. They really kind of popularized it, as you know. Again, my top three favorite bands ever in the top three are the Byrds. But these albums are really lovely, too. This is a fun song. It's interesting how things change in terms of colloquialisms. And there's a song called Oh Daddy, Be Gay. Not that there's anything wrong with that song, but I'm sure it had a different meaning back then. Again, someone who didn't get a lot of credit, street cred, although some other people covered his songs. And I'm going to cover this most famous song. Not cover it, but I'm going to play his most famous song here. Just a great song. Sorry. Again, another artist who was on Vanguard Records. But this is... Eric Anderson.
From dirty words.
muddy cells, your clothes are smeared and stained. But the dirty words of muddy cells will soon be judged insane. So only stop to rest yourself till you are off again.
Song called Thirsty Boots.
And you take off your thirsty boots and stay for a while. Your feet are hot and weary from a dusty mile. And maybe I can make you laugh. Maybe
gorgeous song,
I
right?
I'm just looking for.
Didn't you hate when DJs used to talk over the records when you were a kid? And based on this song, I just noticed Harvey Brooks, who, what a great bass player. In fact, you may know him or you know of his bass playing on Super Session with Steve Stills, Al Cooper, Mike Bloomfield. He's the bass player. The original sounds great, but even the remastered CD with the extra track, Season of the Witch, their version, listen to the friggin' bass on that album. Harvey Brooks, what an amazing bass player. But here you go. Okay. Dave Van Ronk. You may not know Dave Van Ronk, but he was also part of the Greenwich Village scene in New York in the early 60s. And, this is on Verve, Folkways, which is part of Verve. I forgot about that. But and here's a version of...
Oh, don't ask why.
Oh, ba-ba-da-ba-ba-ba. But you know this from The Doors, right? Alabama song, Kurt Vile.
Oh, show us the way to the next whiskey bar. Oh, don't ask why. Oh, don't ask why. For we must find the next whiskey bar. Or if we don't find the next whiskey bar.
And there's a song here that it's funny how you learn from different artists. As you know, my favorite guitar player is Ry Cooter. I first heard his version of this song before I ever heard Dave Van Ronk's. You know, you kind of listen to Eric Clapton and Yardbirds and you go back and listen to the original blues. Very similar thing. Inside Llewellyn Davis, loosely based on Dave Van Ronk by the Coen brothers. You know, when I started out this video, I said, folk music, that shit almost caught on. And I say that tongue in cheek. There's, I can't remember if it was a National Lampoon comedy album, one of their comedy albums, and they kind of did a thing with folk music, and that shit almost caught on. And we played that album in record stores a lot, you know, and all those. People who work in record stores sometimes play records as private jokes to the rest of the audience, to the buyers out in the store. They don't necessarily know what's going on when you play certain tunes. We're assholes. But that was the thing about folk music and the joke about, you know, how precious it was, the anti-war and the movement. And the thing was, it was good stuff. I'm not, but in a way, that was a period of cynicism after that. So I did do a whole video on this next artist, folk singer, but I'm just going to play a very little bit of this from his first album. I did a Phil Oakes. I'm a big Phil Oakes fan. This is his most famous protest song. I Ain't Marching Anymore.
I
And of course, as soon as he said Little Bighorn, it reminded me of another great folk singer I forgot, and one of the great folk singer protest songs of the day, Buffy St. Marie, Universal Soldier. If you don't know her version, I'm sure you probably know Donovan's cover of that on maybe his very first album before he got kind of British folky, Crystal Images psychedelic. You know, that's a good one too. But again, not definitive. Just I think it's time for you to listen to folk music, get into the Americana thing. I'm going to end up, well, almost end up. I'm going to show you one more thing after this, but Fred Neil. You know a couple of Fred Neil's songs, possibly. One's Dolphins, has been covered by a lot of artists, including, I think, fucking Led Zeppelin singer. That's one of his solo albums. I think he does Dolphins. But the one song you'll definitely know is this song. At least some of you older people might know it, but everyone else has probably heard it on a radio. Ooh. Got some issues going on there. This is the version that came out after he had recorded it. It became the theme to Midnight Cowboy, sung by Nielsen. The irony was, Nielsen was asked to write a song for the theme of the movie, and he wrote Boy in New York City, and ended up using it in the end credits. And Nielsen's cover of this was the hit at the title. I think it bummed him out a little bit. Anyway, that's pretty much it. Just I'm going to show you a CD set that I've had for years from Rhino 2001, and it's Washington Square Memories, the Great Urban Folk Boom from 1950 to 1970. Kind of a cool overview. Obviously conspicuous in his absence of Dylan because of rights and you know how that goes. It'd be nice if record companies could get along sometime and allow other artists, but I mean, there's everything from Big Bill Brunzi to Josh White to Malvina Reynolds, Little Boxes, you know that song maybe. The Weavers, Glenn Yarborough, Kingston Trio, Odetta, Pete Seeger, The Journeymen, Bob Gibson and Bob Camp, Ramblin' Jack Elliott, he's someone I forgot too. He would have been a good person to be here. Hoyt Axton, Dave Van Ron, Rooftop Singers. Again, if you want to learn about the definitive thing about folk music, rent A Mighty Wind. Christopher Guest's good parody on, mockumentary on it. Really hysterical. And it really nails it. Buffy St. Marie is on here. Codine. Hamilton Camp. Richie and Mima Farina. Gordon Lightfoot. So it goes beyond just New York. Gordon Lightfoot's Canadian. David Blue. Tom Rush. Taj Mahal. Arlo Guthrie. Loudon Wainwright. I love Loudon Wainwright. I think I just saw Loudon Wainwright. Who was, I'm sorry, I'm forgetting your name. The Irish guy. Oh, there's a Dylan, does Boots of Spanish Leather, is on here. My mistake. Anyway, I'm gonna go protest something and pour myself a cocktail and protest that Sunday's fucking over. Thank you for watching. Mazzy loves you.